Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Karo and Zsolna Fehér. There are so many applications of deep learning, I was really excited to put together a short but really cool list of some of the more recent results for you fellow scholars to enjoy. Machine learning provides us an incredible set of tools. If you have a difficult problem at hand, you don't need to handcraft an algorithm for it. It finds out by itself what is important about the problem and tries to solve it on its own. In many problem domains, they perform better than human experts. What's more, some of these algorithms find out things that you could earn a PhD with 10 years ago. Here goes the first stunning application. Toxicity detection for different chemical structures by means of deep learning. It is so efficient that it could find toxic properties that previously required decades of work by humans who are experts of their field. Next one, mitosis detection from large images. Mitosis means that cell nuclei are undergoing different transformations that are quite harmful and quite difficult to detect. The best techniques out there are using convolutional neural networks and are outperforming professional radiologists at their own task. Unbelievable. Kaggle is a company that is dedicated to connecting companies with large datasets and data scientists who write algorithms to extract insight from all this data. If you take only a brief look, you see an incredibly large swath of applications for learning algorithms. Almost all of these were believed to be only for humans, very smart humans. And learning algorithms, again, emerged triumphant on many of these. For instance, they had a great competition where learning algorithms would read a website and find out whether paid content is disguised there as real content. Next up on the list, hallucination or sequence generation. It looks at different video games, tries to learn how they work, and generates new footage out of thin air by using a recurrent neural network. Really amazing. Because of the imperfection of the 3D scanning procedures, many 3D scanned furnitures are too noisy to be used as is. However, there are techniques to look at these really noisy models and try to figure out how they should look by learning the symmetries and other properties of real furnitures. These algorithms can also do an excellent job at predicting how different fluids behave in time and are therefore expected to be super useful in physical simulation in the following years. And on the list of highly sophisticated scientific topics, there is this application that can find out what makes a good selfie and how good your photos are, if you really want to know the truth. Here is another application where a computer algorithm that we call deep Q learning plays Pong against itself and eventually achieves expertise. The machines are also grading student essays. At first, one would think that this cannot possibly be a good idea. And as it turns out, their judgment is more consistent with the reference grades than any of the teachers who were tested. This could be an awesome tool for saving a lot of time and assisting the teachers to help their students learn. This kind of blows my mind. It would be great to take a look at an actual dataset if it is public and the issued grades. So if any of you fellow scholars have seen it somewhere, please let me know in the comment section. And these results are only from the last few years, and it's really just scratching the surface. There are literally hundreds of more applications we haven't even talked about. We are living extremely exciting times indeed. I am eager to see and perhaps be a small part of this progress. There are tons of reading and viewing materials in the description box. Check them out. Thanks for watching and for your generous support, and I'll see you next time.